and machines at war. Wool prepared for spinning and weaving. Wool for uniforms. Wool for blankets. Wool for our army, our air force, and our navy. But not all this work is done by great machines of steel. The humble wooden spinning wheel is at work once more, at work for the Navy. In Wellington and other centres, volunteer workers of the New Zealand Navy League are busy teasing and carding the greasy natural wool to make special garments to keep out cold and wet. They prepare it by hand and spin it by hand as in ages past, for only the thickest natural hand-spun wool is good enough for the job. This spinner gained her skill in the Shetland Isles, where such women's arts have not been lost. Some learnt to spin on the Scottish border. They have taught others, and spinning wheels of every type, this one a converted sewing machine, are turning out the thick wool that retains its natural oil. Wool to protect the men who guard our ships. Many of these voluntary workers have husbands and sons at sea. All have found out for themselves how they can best help win this war. Here's the finished wool, ready for knitting. And yet one more type of wheel at work for the Navy. Meanwhile, more women of the same group are busy with needles. They are doing their part in the self-set tasks of the Navy League. Their work produces not ordinary socks, but giant sea boot stockings, made for the men who stand for hours on decks awash with cold seas, or on watch amidst ice and snow. One pair of these stockings weighs 2 pounds. From other wool is knitted jerseys, balaclavas, mittens, scarves. These things go to our own men in New Zealand ships, to Britain for the men of the Royal Navy and Merchant Marine, clothing made by New Zealand women from New Zealand wool. The work is directed by the wife of New Zealand's Commodore. These goods may go to sailors who fight the long battle of the Atlantic, to men who guard the Empire's lifelines, to clothe the men who sail in northern waters where the night is long and the cold grey sea is slowly turning to ice, to the men who sweep for mines, to men who fight while women spin.